Mr. Chris Kearney and Ms. Judy Marks. Dr. Okina. Ms. Muang Yuan Lee and Mr. Jeff Warner. Mr. Hoshide. Mr. Kobayashi. Mr. Ninami. Mr. Fink. Mr. Masayoshi. Mr. Haas. Mr. and Mrs. May Rocha. The Honorable Richard T. Bisson, Jr. and Mrs. Isabella Bisson. Mr. and Mrs. Walker. Ms. Yamaguchi and Ms. Sayusa. The Honorable Tony Evers and Mrs. Kathy Evers. Ms. Naomi Biden Neal and Mr. Peter Neal. Representative Matsui and Mr. Sant. Mr. Maeda Tarashi. Ms. Nakayama, and Ms. Ida Nakayama. Mr. Stavis and Mrs. Stavis. Mr. and Mrs. Banga. Mrs. James and Mr. Peterson. Mr. Sawada Jun. The Honorable Nelson and Mrs. Nelson. Mr. and Mrs. Roche. The Honorable Wesley and Mrs. Wesley. The Honorable David Cohen and Miss Cohen.
Representative DeGette and the Honorable Lipinski de Orloff. Sir, Admirable Grady and Mrs. Grady. Miss Toller and Miss Albert. Miss Nakashima Urinal and Mr. Urinal. Mr. Kauai. Yep. Mr. and Mrs. Rogan. Mr. and Mr. Smith.
Aww, welcome.
The Honorable Benjamin and Miss Benjamin. The Honorable Macaro and Mrs. Macaro. Mr. O'Donnell, Miss O'Donnell and Mr. Ake. Mr. Zapolsky and Miss Hubbard. The Honorable Powell and Mrs. Powell. Mr. Woods and Miss Wooden. Mr. Walker and Miss Walsh. Mr. Mikitani Hiroshi. Miss Gonzalez and Mr. Lubrano.
Yeah.
Ms. and Mr. Gelman. The Honorable Podesta and Ms. Podesta. The Honorable Shapiro and Mrs. Shapiro. Mr. and Mrs. Krishna. Mr. and Miss Shibutani. Mr. Mr. and Dr. Booker. Mr. Goodman and Miss Lipman. Mr. and Mrs. Gray. Mr. Takano, Mr. Fukushima. Mr. and Mrs. Hostetter. Ambassador Tai and Mr. Skidmore. Miss Leela. Mr. Ayase. Honorable Crittenbrick and Mrs. Crittenbrick. Mr. Bezos and Miss Sanchez. The Honorable Harrell and Mrs. Harrell. The Honorable Granholm and Mr. Mulhern. Mr. Shingle. Mrs. Resnick and Mr. Resnick. The Honorable Tomasini and Mr. Tomasini. The Honorable Ricchetti and Mrs. Ricchetti. Mr. and Mrs. Donnellan. The Honorable Hochul and Mr. Hochul. The Honorable Burns and Miss Burns. The Honorable Vowles and Miss Smith.
The Honorable Campbell.
This is my daughter, Zoe.
All right.
Yeah, Richard.
Okay. Excellent. Welcome. The Honorable Verma and Miss Verma. Senator Merkley and Miss Merkley. Mr. and Mrs. Diamond.
Sir, thank you.
Representative Tokuda and Miss Morita. The Honorable Emmanuel and Miss Rule. Mr. Zechariah Emmanuel and Miss Alana Emmanuel. The Honorable Reed and Miss Lepard. Miss Richards and Mr. Adams. Miss Nakashima and Mr. Cyprus. The Honorable Hochstein and Mrs. Ringel. Senator Hirono and Mr. Oshima. Mr. and Mrs. Sachs. Mr. and Miss Bloom. Mr. De Niro and Miss Chan. Mr. Mosteller. General Brown and Mrs. Brown. Mr. I. Canner and Mr. Luong. The Honorable Dr. Mira Rapp Hooper and Mr. Brest.
Senator Hagerty and Mrs. Hagerty. President Clinton and Secretary Clinton. Mr. Freeman and Mr. Loftus. The Honorable John Bass and Ms. Shia. The Honorable Dr. Lael Brainard. The Honorable Linda Thomas Greenfield and Mr. Greenfield. The Honorable Alejandro Mayorkas, Secretary of Homeland Security, and Mrs. Mayorkas. The Honorable Vadi and Mrs. Vadi. The Honorable Philip Gordon, National Security Advisor to the Vice President, and the Honorable Rebecca Lissner, Deputy Security Advisor to the Vice President. The Honorable Roy Cooper, Governor of North Carolina, and Mrs. Cooper. Ms. Ashley Biden and Ms. Finnegan Biden. The Honorable Janet Yellen, Secretary of the Treasury, and the Honorable Adewale Adeyemo, Deputy Secretary of the Treasury. The Honorable Gina Raimondo, Secretary of Commerce, and Mr. Andy Moffitt.
Thank you. ago, a big, shiny, blue and red envelope covered with stickers on the envelope. It was a big envelope and was full of letters from an elementary school teacher in Japan who compiled them from her students. She teaches children who stutter, like I did as a child. And she wanted me to know that when she told them, her class, about that I had a similar liability at the time, the kids lit up, smiling, and they said, "We're the same. We're the same." Well, we are the same, Japan and the United States. Many, we may be divided by distance, but the generations after generation, we've been brought together, the same hopes, the same values, the same commitment to democracy and freedom, and to dignity for all. And today, without question, our alliance is literally stronger than it has ever been. This was both not inevitable, but it was also, the fact is, that both the Prime Minister and I came of age as our countries were, as they came together. We both remember the choices that were made to forge a friendship that were once only a devastating fight that existed before. We both remember that hard work, what it has done to find healing, and where there was once such hardship. We both remember Japanese and American people who not only brought us together, but who brought us forward, transforming our relationship from bitter foes to the best friends could be. Tonight, we pledge to keep going. We stand at an inflection point where the decisions we make now are going to determine the course of the future for decades to come, a future that the kids of our two families and children and all of our two countries remember. But I also know that Japan and the United States stand together, and everyone should know that as well, committed to each other and committed to keeping building a future worthy of the highest hopes of our predecessors and our people have dreamed of. Ladies and gentlemen, so please join me in raising your glass, and I don't have a glass. There you go. You have one for the Prime Minister?
Thank you.
Join me in raising your glasses to our alliance, to our friendship, and in the words of those young students in Japan, to the same future we share. Cheers.
Cheers.
I'll turn it over to you, Mr. Prime Minister. Thank you.
Mr. President, Dr. Biden, distinguished guests, and ladies and gentlemen, I would like to express my heartfelt gratitude to you for hosting such a wonderful dinner and your warm welcome and hospitality. Before I came here, my protocol staff told me that no one had ever complained that my speech was too short. This is probably good advice, so I'll keep my speech short. First and foremost, to be honest, my breath is taken and I'm speechless in front of such a huge number of prominent American and Japanese guests. My wife, Yuko, also left breathless, just told me that it was hard to tell who the guest of honor is. So I was relieved when I was shown the seat right next to the president. last year, President Biden and Dr. Biden visited my hometown of Hiroshima to attend the G7 summit meeting. It is a little known fact that the largest number of Japanese immigrants to the United States came from Hiroshima. many Hiroshimans headed to the United States to seek a new world, a better future, and greater heights. Mr. President, I know that the late Senator Daniel Inoue was a good friend of yours. His mother was also from Hiroshima. Looking back at the long history of Japan and the United States, our predecessors have carved out the path in various fields, such as business, academia, art and sports, traveling back and forth between the two countries. The Pacific Ocean does not separate Japan and the United States. Rather, it unites us. These were the words that President Kennedy sent to Prime Minister Ikeda, also hailing from Hiroshima, at the state luncheon held at the White House about 60 years ago. I like this line. I use it so many times that my staff tried deleting it whenever this phrase appeared on speech drafts. However, there is nothing that expresses our relationship as visibly as this. And never have these words been more relevant than today. Japan and the United States are united than ever before. I believe that the Pacific Ocean has brought Japan and the United States together and so close because of the pioneering spirit of those who came before us and frontier spirit that we all have in common. The success of those standing on the frontier is not just because of their individual efforts, but also the result of collective efforts as a team. This holds true even between nations. Our joint efforts are variable and dispensable for our bright future and for the peace and stability of the world. We are now standing at the turning point in history, embarking on a new frontier on elevate this unshakable Japan-US relationship to even greater heights and hand it to the next generation. Finally, let me conclude with a line from Star Trek, which you all know. To boldly go where no one has gone before. By the way, Joji Takei, who played Hikaru Suru, the helmsman of the USS Enterprise, also has roots in Hiroshima. Mr. President, Dr. Biden, distinguished guests, and ladies and gentlemen, I would like to propose a toast to our voyage to the frontier of the Japan-US relationship with this world, bold ego. And boldly go. Cheers.
Good job. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, Walker, can you unplug that? Can you unplug
our
for me?
Thank you.